Good morning and happy day, everyone! Welcome to the Center for Spiritual Living, Kelowna! How'd you get up this morning?
Woke up this morning with my mind.
How about you? Hey, Sherman and Barry, come on in!
Woke up this morning with my mind. Stay.
Good morning, Arnella!
Woke up this morning with my mind. Stay.
For each other and ourselves.
on your feet for another one if you like. This song is called Your Love Keeps Lifting Me Higher. How you like the way I'm moving today? Thanks for the prayers.
Your love keeps lifting me higher than I've ever been lifted before. So keep it up, quench my desire. I'll be at your side forevermore. Now once I was downhearted, disappointment was my closest friend. But then God came, ooh, and it soon departed. Don't you know I never ever felt that way again?
Come on, you know your love.
Your love keeps lifting me, keeps on lifting me, lifting me higher and higher, higher. I said your love keeps on lifting me, keep on lifting me, lifting me higher and higher.
Well, I'm so glad that I finally found you. You're that one in a million love. And with your love, ooh, your loving arms around me, well, I can stand up the world again.
Get up.
You know your love.
Your love keeps lifting me.
Come on.
Keeps on lifting me. Lifting me higher and higher.
Life streamers.
I said your love
keeps on lifting me.
Lifting me higher and higher.
Here's our horn.
Ba ba da ba 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 da ba.
Life streamers.
Ba da ba da ba da. Ba-da-ba-da-ba-da.
Where's that horn?
Ba-ba-da-ba, ba-ba-da-ba, ba-da-ba-da-ba-da, ba-da-ba-da-ba-da.
I said your love keeps on lifting. Woo!
Ah, lifting me higher and higher. I said your love keeps on.
Woo!
Lifting me higher and higher.
Come on up, friend. Come on up. The tough act to follow. Sheesh. Well, it is just such a pleasure to look out and see so many of you out there and so many of our old friends. Oh my gosh. I could not be happier. On a beautiful summer Sunday morning here in the room. It's full, it's beautiful, and of course, our live love streamers as well. I'm really grateful that we can offer this both ways, and then even, you know, we offer, so cool these days, is on demand. So if you miss here, you can go on YouTube and watch it whenever the desire strikes you. So this technology is good. And I am grateful for us to be together, and however that is, in the thing that we call spiritual community. And you know, we join together to do spiritual practices together. We hear every Sunday an inspiring message, all done with that intention of awakening all of us to our spiritual magnificence. And what I know is as we do that, that awakening helps to contribute to a world that works for everyone. And I am also grateful that we are a community that welcomes all. There is no place that isn't welcome here. We honor our differences, we celebrate diversity, and because we know in the end, there is only one thing happening, and that is the unity of all life. And that includes all life, the animal life, the planet life, all of it. And so what I really think is I think, now maybe I'm a little bit biased, this is true, but I think that we offer the world something that when I look out there these days, it looks like it is crying out for more love. And so I sort of see it akin to, you know, a child who is acting out. What do they want? They want love, they want attention, and so I think that we are beautifully placed in sort of the next iteration of the world to to offer more and more of that out there. So we come together as spiritual community to get our love meters filled up, so then we can spill that out into the world. So just a couple of things. We had our town hall meeting last Sunday, and I am grateful for those who came out for that. I did give a short recap of that for my in my Happy Monday blog last Monday, and you can see that on our website. And what we talked about mostly was, what does this community look like, and what will we look like post-pandemic? And we also shared, Reverend Jeanette shared as our Board of Trustees president, that we are good. We are a healthy, whole, stable community for these times. We also talked about trying to get a sense of, you know, rather than myself or Reverend Corinne or the board saying, this is what we think you should have, we wanted to sort of get a sense about what the community might be looking for as fall comes upon us, and, you know, maybe what might be missing. And what we got, at least from those people, and if it's different for you, please, please let me know. People are pretty happy being back. You know, there's still some hesitation for sure. But the thing that I heard is what people want most are ways to connect and to know that our world is a stable and good place. The other thing I heard, and I just want to put these words into the universe for all of us, is the intention of attracting younger people and families and kids. And so if you know families and children and all of that, so please invite a friend, because in the end, social media and all that good stuff, in the end, word of mouth is still the best marketing that there is. So we are setting the stage for the fall and the process that will sort of be leading up into my retirement at the end of the year. And we also talked about what an important time that is going to be for this community, because what you're going to be charged with is creating your own mental equivalent, your own form for what your next senior minister holds as a vision and is important. So your voice in the next steps is going to be very, very important. So we have some good stuff coming up too. This coming Friday, we're going to have a barbecue at Ken's at my house. You're making me clean my oven, which is a very good thing. So this is a gratitude dinner for those of us who are on our Conscious Givers program here. Those people that have chosen to pledge and to give regularly to be that solid, solid foundation of our financial support, something that we can be counting on for our budget and moving forward, because everything that happens here comes about because of your support. Our music, our speakers, our place, our ability to live stream, all of it comes from you, and that foundation of those conscious givers is so, so support. I would be willing to say we probably would maybe not be here if it wasn't for that constant support. So thank you, and we will see you on Friday. You do need to RSVP to that, though, on our website so we can do right things for that. Also, we've got two classes coming up. Reverends Corinne and Diane Hockey are going to be offering what is called Quick Start. So it's a whole day program, which is, it can either be a for people who are brand new, you want the down and dirty of what science of mind is, or if you want the perfect just reminders of all the most important things, that will be in there as well. So that is on Saturday, September 21st. It's going to be right here. And then Corinne and I are going to facilitate a new class to us, and it's called Spiritual Principles and Practices, which you can probably figure out what that's going to be about. So we're going to offer that two ways. It's kind of our little experiment. We're going to offer the same class both online and in person. So all the information for that is on the website, and you do need to register for that and to pick whether you're an online or an in-person person. And it's only 5 weeks, so it's kind of, again, a quick taste of practices. And so now it's time in our service for some spiritual practices. And I love that we lead into our time of prayer and a little bit of silent time with the spiritual practice of a song. Our music, I find, is one of the most powerful practices that we have in terms of lifting our vibrations into those sweet, sacred spaces. And after the music, Reverend Barb is going to be doing the spiritual mind treatment for us today as well. So thank you for being here, and I'll turn it over.
Thank you, Dr. Deborah.
In this very room, there's quite enough love for all the world. And in this very room, there's quite enough joy for all the world. And there's quite enough peace and quite enough power to walk through our every fear. For one spirit is in this very
Reverend Jeanette.
Centered and grounded into this eternal present moment right here and right now, I invite you to take these words as your own if you choose. And so this is what I know. I know there is one power and one presence, one source of all things and everything. And so in this moment, I consciously unify with this power and this presence. I breathe and I allow that infilling of spirit. And so spirit bubbling, permeating, filling every cell of my being with every breath, with every heartbeat, I feel the power and presence of spirit right at my core. And so I speak my word for this group that's here gathered, knowing that each of us are here by divine appointment. And so I know that this morning's service is blessed. I know that we each receive exactly what it is we need to hear and exactly the message that works for us. And so I know as we step into that life uncommon, all of the possibilities become apparent. All that is required is to know that this is spirit, to know that this is love, and to know that all we need to do is step into those parts and pieces that are next as we relax and allow that eternal flow of substance in, as, and through every piece of our being. And so trusting in this and knowing this, all that's required is to say, thank you, God, thank you, Spirit. And so as I relax and allow and release, I demand these words become manifest in the form of our experience right here and right now. And so I speak this word, I release this word, I bless it, I surrender it, and together we say, and so it is.
Receive this song. It's called Bridge Over Troubled Water.
When you're weary,
Thank you. Thank you. That's Neil Clausen. Thank you so much. Keep your love and your energy coming for Reverend Corinne Crockett!
Thank you, Barb and Neil. Thank you, everyone. What a morning of big feels. Today, I'm grateful for waterproof mascara yet again. It feels like something so big and so wonderful is happening within our spiritual community is, as I know I am not alone in witnessing the flow of a divine good in through our center in a way like, I'm not going to say never before, but it's refreshing and it's wonderful. So good morning to my beloved community. I am full of feels today. As I recognize and know the privilege of coming to speak to you each and every week, to be here with you each week. And you know, it's always kind of fun for me preparing with a talk, because divine mind, I know Pat Campbell calls it the muses, have a way of playing with us as we're preparing a talk. And as I prepare, I can watch spirit unfolding, and it's delightful to see what spirit points the way that I need to learn and then to share with you. You see, I know nothing is separate,
as above, so below. And what's on the inner for me is always reflected on the outer, in the world of effect and in the world of experience. And that is true for all of us. And so this week I kind of cracked up because I'm watching, I'm paying attention, right? Spirit, what would you have me do? What would you have me say? Where would you have me go? What would you have me say and to who? And this week, actually, something kind of creepy happened. And it certainly caught my attention. And I'm actually curious if you've experienced the same thing. And so my husband, Tom, who some of you know, was talking about purchasing this thing called a jackery. Anybody heard of a jackery? Yeah, it's actually this, they're skookum. They're a solar device that are independent, that are an independent power source. Right? That's not the creepy part. What caught my attention was within a very short period of time, on my social media feed, were advertisements not only for the jackery, but for every other brand of external device. And they continued. I checked this morning. They continue to flow in. So despite the fact that we've been kind of careful, right? Like we've rejected Siri and Alexa and smart TV and all of that stuff, it seems that our devices are always listening, trying to offer us that match, not only to our internet searches, but to the conversations that are happening in our home. Creepy. And so what has that got to do with today, and what has that got to do with religious science and the way the universe works? How is this a metaphysical demonstration that I could bring into the room for you? Well, for me, this graphically reminded me of the metaphysical truth that there is a responsive force that is always listening and responding to my thinking and feeling nature. You see, before entering this teaching, I have to say I lived as a little bit of a victim in life because I did not understand the nature of creation. I was absolutely unaware that the universe would always send to me, even via social media, things that corresponded to my thinking, feeling nature. Divine mind, the law of creation, the way it works is always saying yes. What I focus on increases. I'm seeing heads nodding. You see, I may not want or even recognize the match the universe offers me. And pre this teaching, I often did not. Because my thinking and feeling nature wasn't necessarily what I wanted to replicate. But it must come that way because that is the way divine law works. Thought plus feeling equals creation. Simple equation. And so right now I would like to offer you a little opportunity. I'm going to ask you to play with me in a thing that I call contrast learning. Are you willing to play?
I'll play.
Okay. Trust me in this. I'm going to ask you to trust me. And at home, try this out for yourself too and notice. And so I'm going to invite you, if you're comfortable, to close your eyes and just go within. And if you're not comfortable closing your eyes, just gaze at the floor. And I'm going to invite you to bring that very powerful thing called your awareness to your breath. It's just like gently swooping the spotlight of your attention, your consciousness, on noticing your breath. Feeling your bottom seated on the chair. Noticing your feet on the floor and that inflow and the outflow of the breath into and through your body. Feeling the breath rather than thinking about it. Allowing all thoughts to simply float away and just gently returning awareness back to the breath, back to the present moment and now. And now, if you're willing, I'm going to ask you to bring to mind a situation in your life or in the world that's causing you concern or challenge. Don't please start with the hardest thing or the biggest thing, but start with something small. It could be the drivers in Kelowna or in your hometown or some delay, some concern you're having. But I'm going to invite you to bring to mind a concern or an irritation, a frustration in your life. And if it's too much, just return to the breath if it's too uncomfortable. But if you're willing, just for a couple of minutes, to bring a challenging situation. Could be a politician, something personal, something you disagree with. Don't worry, I'm not going to leave you here, I promise. But what I'm going to invite you to do now is start to notice how you feel. How do you feel inside in response to this thought? How do your muscles feel? How does your heart feel? What is your mind doing as you're entertaining this thought of annoyance? You might even be annoyed with me, actually, for bringing this up, daring to do this on a Sunday. So just pay attention to what's happening inside of you in response to this one brief thought of challenge. Okay. And now I'm going to invite you to let that thought float away like a cloud and just bring your awareness back to the breath, back to feeling the breath. And imagining that breath just entering your body and filling you up right down to your belly, and then letting go on the exhale, clearing and cleansing and letting go. So you feel the breath as it enters and leaves. Remembering the other name for the breath is inspiration. Feeling that breath. Any thoughts that enter in, just let them float away like clouds in the sky. And maintain that awareness on the breath for just a couple more breaths. And now just move that precious spotlight of your awareness down to your heart. And taking that awareness, if it's helpful to put your hand there, your fingers there at the heart, just do that. But just bringing that precious awareness down to the heart center in the middle of your chest and taking a moment to check in with the state of your heart right now. And how does your heart feel? Is it opened or closed or soft or hard? Maybe it's hard to tell. The heart has its own natural rhythm of opening and closing, closing and opening. And seeing if you can feel or imagine that gentle, steady rhythm of your heart. Sensing or imagining that gentle, steady rhythm of your beautiful heart nurturing and nourishing your body. And now, slowing the breath ever so slightly. Imagine, if you can, breathing in and out of the heart. If you can imagine your breath flowing in and out of the heart. And noticing how that feels. And if it feels right and true for you, you can invite that heart center to just open a little bit more. As you bring to mind someone or something for whom you have care, compassion, or gratitude, it could be a person or a pet or a situation in your life, someone you love, something you're grateful for. And now within your mind's eye, really thinking about someone or something that you care for, that you love, that you appreciate. Picturing this as beautifully as you can in your mind, as you continue to breathe ever so slowly in and out of the heart. And noticing how that feels within you. Now we come to a really delicious part of imagining a beam of light, any color you want, radiating from your beautiful heart out to surround this object of your love and appreciation, this person for whom you care and are grateful for. You might be called to put a gentle smile on your lips as you imagine this beautiful beam of light radiating from your heart to surround and caress and care for this object of your appreciation and love. And then Notice how that feels within your body. How are the muscles? How is the heart? How is the mind? Let's just send them all another beautiful beam of light, another lovely piece of love surrounding them as we then just take a breath into our belly. One more deep breath into the belly, and then coming back to the room and opening your eyes. This is like watching heaven on earth. Could you feel the energy change? Did you notice a difference inside of you? Could you feel the difference between the two states of thinking about something that was an annoyance and something that you love and appreciate? Could you feel the difference? Mm-hmm. Yes. I could feel the difference even up here. And it's so interesting, as people who work in awareness, and I know we all know this, so I'm probably preaching to the choir, but it's that place of really recognizing that thought plus feeling equals creation. And universal law does not care what we think and feel. It just says yes. It always is saying yes to that place of our attention, matching the resonant atmosphere we create. And the question is, do we really want that divine law to say yes to our thinking and feeling nature when it has been seduced by the world of negative effect? We're in really interesting times, and I just love the way that Deb opened. I love Jeanette's treatment because it all is that one thing. Guys, we are the cultural creatives. Despite what it looks like in the outer world with all the upheaval that's happening, these are the times we've been waiting for and preparing for. It's now. And we alone govern where we spend our time and mind. And what I've really noticed is that seductive nature of what's negative or troublesome or scary. You noticed it too? Yeah. You see, it's an interesting thing is that our mind finds negativity kind of sexy and seductive, and it's a little bit stickier, those negative thoughts. Have you ever noticed that? Got to go into my special pocket here just a moment. Do you know it's interesting to say that it actually takes five positives to offset one negative? That's the way the inherent negativity bias works. And so as cultural creatives, it's actually really good to start to really practice where we are spending our energy and time and mind. Are we spending that time on what is challenging and hard, or on what we appreciate, care for, and love? What side are we feeding? And right now we're being offered this prime opportunity in the world, being seduced by what's toughest, all of the dross, Dr. Ken languages it, the tough stuff that's floating up to be cleared. You see, what's interesting, and I know that Reverend Barb spoke a few weeks ago about the vibrational state with Dr. Houghton's work, right? That you can feel that difference of a higher energy or a lower energy within our body. And that second state, that heart-centered state, the state of love, is a very powerful place of creation to consciously create the good that we desire within our lives. Conscious thought centered in high vibration of love is actually incredibly powerful. And it's not about spiritual bypass. I don't advocate for that. But it's about making a positive separation about which thoughts we are going to nourish. And so in the climate of today's world, it's actually really easy to be seduced by what's prevalent in the media, including Jackery. But what is important to remember is the recipe for creating good in our lives is buried right in plain sight in all of the sacred texts, in all of the wisdom traditions. What our founder, Dr. Ernest Holmes, did was he combined all of these wisdom traditions into one teaching. Biblically, it actually says in Philippians 4:18, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent and praiseworthy, think about such things. Yeah. But why? Well, you know I love science. And so from a personal and very physical perspective, it's important to consider that we are the first people to experience our thoughts. Have you ever thought about that? Especially if you're going down the road and there's some poor driver and he's really annoying you. I am suffering inside my body because I'm thinking bad thoughts about him. Like, why would I do that? Crazy. Each thought we practice creates neural connections in our brain. And what we think about repeatedly becomes hardwired and becomes our mental tendency. And what we think about comes about. And then we have the internal pharmacy in our body. Every thought creates a corresponding chemical cascade within our body. Various hormones and chemicals that are a match to our thinking nature are secreted into our cells in response to our thoughts, creating the feelings that we experience. And so much like the practice we engaged in a few minutes ago, we experience the effects of our thoughts, positive or challenging or neutral. And if we're not aware of our inherent creative power, and we stay subject then to what religious scientists call the law of averages, and there is not an average person in this room, we're called to rise above being average, as New Thought teacher Raymond Charles Barker wrote. Your mind determines your experience. Gone are the negative beseechings to a distant power. Today, great masses of people are aware of the nature of life as you live it, here and now, has within itself the creative power of accomplishment. And this line, his next line, I love. But only those who dare to emerge from the accepted beliefs of the crowd can prove it. We in this room, we online, if you are tuned in to this place, we are called to emerge from the accepted beliefs of the crowd. Guys, we can't wait for anybody else. It's up to you, it's up to me to do this, to leave the crowd behind and start leading it another way into love, which we know is the only power. And to recognize and know that beyond our very personal experience of it all, that our thinking and feeling nature also affects and creates in the global world that we live in. We are not isolated and alone. My thoughts are not private thoughts. Didn't we find that out with Jackery? Ain't nothing private in this world, and that law of mind, it responds to me even more quickly than Jackery and Siri and Alexa do. And science proves this with random events generators and studies that have been done with, like, Lynn McTaggart. And so not only are we the author of our own experience, but then we as individuals contribute to the creation of the collective consciousness of the world we live in. It is a vibratory universe. Our founder, Dr. Holmes, tells us, and I love this, the soul life of all people merges, and this creates the soul life of the race. The collective subjectivity of all humanity, called by some the collective unconscious. We all know we're seeing a whole lot of the collective unconscious being bantered about in the world right now, right? And so Dr. Holmes continues, we are all more or less subject to this collective thought, since it acts as a powerful race suggestion. The sum total of all erroneous human beliefs binds until the individual mentally lifts himself above the law of averages into a higher law of spiritual individualism. Woohoo! Sorry if that was loud online. And so what he reminds us is to assert our individuality is to rise above the law of averages into the more highly specialized use of the law, which brings freedom rather than bondage, joy in the place of grief, and wholeness instead of sickness. Are we all for that?
All for it.
Yes. And so the point is, and this is where we have to stay pristine within our minds, is that what we are experiencing today and in the world is the effect of the collective thoughts from the past. And if we keep mired in this, if we keep judging it, being annoyed by it, giving it our power, giving it our attention and feeling, we add more crap to what's already there. We have a teaching that tells us we can change this. It is up to us to change this. We know this stuff. But as Van Gogh said, we must apply. And so by learning and practicing the principles of teaching of this teaching, I'm getting too excited. We are the ones that we have been waiting for. It is up to us. This is our call. This is our call to action. It is up to us as individuals to answer this call to actively participate. For me, it's in mental hygiene, letting go of a whole lot of old BS, to create the future universe that I want to leave for my kids and grandkids. Because either we are maintaining what's currently in place and adding our energy to support the maintenance and expansion of the challenges that we're currently experiencing, or we're rising above the so-called battleground of the world of effect with our consciousness. We're putting our eyes away from what is challenging to make a conscious difference in the world to raise our view to what we want, and it is up to us. As Carl Jung wrote, what we focus on increases. And so, my beautiful cultural creatives in this room and online, what culture do we want to create? You see, what is taught here in this teaching of science of mind is meant to empower us not to be a victim to the world, not to stand in judgment of, oh my God, what are they doing? How crazy are they? It is up to us to shift our gaze and to be the conscious creators of the world that we want to live in. Our time is now to begin using these spiritual principles, or to continue, double down on using these spiritual principles of this teaching. Things such as spiritual mind treatment, mindfulness, the class Deb and I are teaching, that Diane and I will be teaching. Remembering that you're never alone. The universe is always listening. But what do you want it to hear? So to quote Dr. Holmes, he said, "There is a power for good in this universe greater than you are. And you can use it." And so court divine presence and spend time learning and growing, hanging out with high-minded individuals like we're doing today, having caution with those social media feeds. And all of these things go a long way in supporting us to be powerful emanations of the divine world that we want to create. The world needs us more than ever. And so in this room and tuned into this talk, I know I'm preaching to the choir. We are the cultural creatives, but a reminder is always good. And not succumbing to the law of averages, rising above the battleground is essential. We can't play down there and dirty. It's vital to continue to apply and use what we know from this teaching and reach out for help when you need to. And so to quote Jewel from her song, Life Uncommon. And I'm so grateful to Gwen for coming in today. I want you to really take these words in and listen to every word of the song as Gwen sings it. No longer lend your strength to that which you wish to be free from. Fill your lives with love and bravery, and you shall lead a life uncommon. Thank you.
I had a call from dear Reverend Corinne. Thank you for this. It's powerful. And it's right. It's true. Hello? Hello? Oh, there we go. So sorry. Okay. And I couldn't come here today. I was doing some favors for a friend and dog sitting.
Stupid dog.
We've captured that now. And it wasn't until last night that we made the decision. And I happened to be with Barb and Neil, and they were so gracious to do this. So here we are, Life in Common. Don't worry, Mother, it'll be all right. And don't worry, Sister, say your prayers and sleep tight. And it'll be fine, lover of mine, it'll be just fine. And lend your voices only to the sounds of freedom. No longer lend your strength to that which you wish to be free from. Fill lives with love and bravery, and you shall lead a life uncommon. I've heard your anguish, I've heard your heart cry out. We are tired, we are weary, but we are worn out. Set down your chains till only faith remains. Down your train and lend your voices only to the sound of freedom. No longer lend your strength to that which you wish to be free from. Fill lives with love and rain, and you shall lead life uncommon. There are plenty of people who pray for peace, but if praying were enough, it would have come to be. Let your words enslave no one, and the heavens will hush themselves to hear. The voices ring out clear with sounds of freedom, with sounds of freedom. Come on, you unbelievers, move out of the way. There is a new army coming, and we are armed with faith. And to live is to give. To live. Here we go. Join me. And lend your voices. Sounds of freedom. No longer lend your strength to that which you wish to be free from. Fill lives with love and bravery, and you shall lead. And lend your and you shall lead a life uncommon. Neil Crossen.
Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. How are we feeling? Feeling full, feeling good, feeling inspired, connected, loved, all of those things? I'm Jeanette Binnick, and I'm the president of our Board of Trustees. And so right here, right now, we get to actually act on the law of circulation. So it's our time of offertory. And so I would invite those beautiful greeters that we had here, if they want to come forward with the baskets, that would be great. And so here's the thing that I know about the law of circulation, is that as we give, so we receive. And as beautiful Reverend Corinne shared in her talk, thought plus feeling equals manifestation. And so just play with me here for a little bit. I want you just to put your hand on your heart, and I want you to feel it. And so just imagine that beautiful circulation that develops where we give, where we get our good, and then that good returns it back to us. And so there's this circulation, a reciprocity of it that serves our center. And so I want you just to feel that, because this is what I know. I know that our center survives and thrives and flourishes from the donations that are lovingly given from this beautiful community. And so I invite you, if you feel comfortable, to repeat these affirmations after me. And so I know that my giving,
I know that my giving
blesses and multiplies,
blesses and multiplies
all that I am,
all that I am,
all that I have,
all that I have,
and all that I give and receive.
All that I give and receive.
And together we say, I do give eternal thanks for the abundance that is mine to share. And so love, peace, and blessings. Thank you for honoring us with your presence today. Thank you.
Wow. What a morning. What a morning. Yes? Two standing ovations. You guys are on tonight, today, this morning. I want to take this moment to recognize Brother Jeff in the house, Jeff Andrews, and his beautiful children, Roy and Liz, and her partner who have come. Jeff has been vital. He was in our music department. He played for years with us. He was my brother from another mother. He has transitioned, and today we will be celebrating him today. And I just want to recognize this beautiful family. I love you, Jeff. We stood for you today, baby. I want to recognize this family. We love you. We're here for you. We support you. We're going to say yes to more coming together. Yes? Yes, yes to more love. Yes. Yes, more to life uncommon. Yes, yes. Get up on your feet. At home, come on. I've seen all your shots out to us. We are so grateful. Yes.
When love comes knocking at my door, I say yes. I say yes.
Sing it out.
When love comes dancing across my floor, I say yes. I say yes. And when I need a little more of what I'm looking for, I know that I am blessed. When I say yes, just say yes. You gotta say yes. Here come the world. The world's a calling now. When the world comes knocking at my door, tap, tap, tap.
I say yes.
I say yes.
I say yes.
Come on in, world. When the world cross my floor, Reverend Gwen, come sing.
She says yes.
I say yes.
She says yes.
Come and sing. When I need a little more of what I'm looking for, I know that I am blessed. When I say yes, just say yes. You gotta say yes.
Sing about the freedom. Come on, freedom.
Let's
come on
freedom.
In.
When freedom comes knocking at my door,
tap, tap, tap.
I say what?
I say yes.
I say yes.
Oh, yeah.
When freedom comes across the
floor. Let's dance, baby.
I say yes.
Ooh, yeah.
I say yes.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
When I need a little more of what I'm looking for, I know that I am blessed. When I say yes, just say yes. You gotta say yes.
You gotta love. The love is calling now.
When love comes knocking at my door,
what you gonna say?
I say yes.
Let me see it.
I say yes.
Come on, love.
When love comes cross my floor.
What you gonna
Go,
do?
Julie.
I say yes.
You're gonna say, let's dance,
I
love.
Say yes.
Woo!
When I need a little more of what I'm looking for, I know that I am blessed. When I say yes,
yes,
just say yes,
yes,
gotta say yes.
we all said yes, and we came this morning. It was a really good morning, wasn't it?
Yes!
Yes. Yes. Say yes to more!